Hello, family. It's me, Apostle Tui.
Apostle Nela. We just want to do a quick little introductory to our study on the kingdoms, two kingdoms, the kingdom of darkness and the kingdom of God, and how your choice can empower which kingdom will operate in your life. So you choose to submit to God, the kingdom of God will operate through you. But if you choose to serve Satan and entertain Satan, his kingdom will be glorified. And so you kind of see in this video, there's a towards the end, there's a deliverance as we're praying. And so you'll probably hear some screaming in the background. That's because there was some young girls who had, they weren't a part of the our ministry, but they had come. We don't know what kind of background that they came from, but something obviously happened, and there was obviously a manifestation, but the praise the Lord, they got delivered and they were healed.
Man, so we're just giving you a warning. If you hear screaming towards the end of the video, it means like the demons are getting exposed. So we can't bring up the kingdom of light and the kingdom of darkness. So we encourage you guys to watch this video. If this is you, this could encourage you to stay and remain in Jesus, because sometimes we start sowing into the flesh. So we can say kingdom of God and flesh, you know, like flesh and spirit, it's the same thing. So God encourages us to stay in spirit and not give an inch to the flesh. So that's the study you'll see in the study, for us to encourage everyone to, if you keep sowing to the kingdom of darkness, you will reap corruption. And if you keep sowing to the spirit, you'll reap everlasting. So enjoy the video. I believe this will encourage you. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.
Who came to the Lord already moving in the power of God? Who gave their life to Jesus having a full understanding of salvation? Myself, I never came to the Lord. I never came to the Lord moving in the power of God. Like, for instance, when I first gave my life to the Lord, the first verse that the Bible is talking about is the first thing you ever did when you came to Christ. What was that? Loving Jesus. Does that make sense? Simply loving Jesus. That's where everything else comes from. That's where your passion to go out and minister. That's where your confidence comes in moving in the power of God. And that's where your passion is to go out and minister to lost souls. Is simply doing this, loving Jesus. And so this is something that the Lord had been ministering to me for a while. And this morning in my thinking of Him, I was asking for a word, and He simply gave me that. This is what it is. God created everything. Genesis 1, 2, God created everything. He created the heavens, He created the earth and everything that is in it. He created the creatures, the animals, He created the grass, He created the rain. In the scriptures it talks about He commanded the sea to come to a certain distance before it goes back in. He commanded the sun and the moon to come up when He commanded them to. And so because God is a God of love, He created these things. And all He did was told them and they obeyed. But then when man created man, they simply rebelled. And it became disobedient. But now we see obedience through the person of Jesus Christ. We see the work that He did. And when He came, He said, to love the Lord your God with all your heart, mind, soul, and strength, and love your neighbor as yourself. And on these two hang the Lord's commandments. Understand this, your ability is different from your character. Power is not character, power is ability. Love is character. Does that make sense? This is not to disregard the preaching on any power or the moving in the power of God. This is to put your identity back into place where the scripture says that God is love and we remain in the likeness of God, therefore we're made in the likeness of love. This is where the power of love comes into play. This is where the knowledge of love is displayed by love. Does that make sense? So, as these guys, as the apostles are getting set up, I just wanted to encourage everyone here to simply, don't complicate the first verse, just simply love Jesus. That was the first thing you did when you first came to Christ. Love Jesus. You gave your life to Christ. We didn't know how to move the power. We didn't know anything about the Bible. We were taught that, but we had this one thing that we had all in common. Love Jesus. Amen. The reason why we went out on the streets, love Jesus. The reason why we preached in the workplace, love Jesus. The reason why we were in our word and we were in prayer is because we love Jesus. And that's all it is. It says, this is what it talks about. You cannot serve two masters. Amen? It's not telling you to try and love one and try and hate the other. It's telling you this. When you love one, by default, you will hate the other. There's no trying to hate sin. There's no trying to hate the world. It's simply loving Jesus, and then everything else by default will fall into place. Does that make sense? Okay. Yeah, so just an encouragement to everyone, even to myself, is to continue in the love of Christ. If you look at Jesus, the way he speaks, he says, if you abide in me and I abide in you, you are my disciple indeed. And like I shared before in the weeks past, that knowing the truth will set you free. That's what Jesus says in John 8:32. And ye shall know the truth, and the truth shall make you free. Yeah, knowing the truth will set you free, but believing in the truth will set you apart. That's what sets you apart. If you look at the verse before that, in verse 31, it says that the Jews that believed on him, he said this to them, if you continue my word, you are my disciples indeed. You are my disciples indeed. So this is what he's saying. If you stick with me, you're set apart from every other Jew that didn't believe. And that's why this is what sets us apart from every other religion, is that we believe our Maker. We believe Jesus. And it sets us apart and sets us free. There's a possibility to be set free and still be conformed to this world. There is a possibility. Because there's the knowledge of the truth. That's what sets you free, yeah? It makes you free. You've got many churches out there that know the truth, but they're still conforming to the world. Because they don't believe the truth. This is what Hebrews talks about. It says, the word that was preached to us was also preached to them, but it didn't profit them because it wasn't mixed with faith. Faith shows that you love. What you believe in shows what you love. Yeah? So this is just a brief encouragement to the brethren to love Jesus, and therefore you will love each other. And love those who are not yet saved to bring them to the kingdom of God. Amen?
Amen.
So God bless you all. Hello, beautiful saints. How are you guys? It's been awesome this week, amen?
Amen.
So me and Apostle Nela was praying downstairs for a word to share with the flock. So the Lord gave us a word today. And the word is the kingdom of God, and behind it is the kingdom of darkness. Okay, so we're going to teach you guys. Whenever it's not done, you're going to tell us what to write on this. So the study is on examination. Okay, so that's the whole study. You want guys to examine the difference between the kingdom of darkness and the kingdom of light. So then we'll show some scriptures. But we're excited about that when the Lord revealed us about stuff downstairs. I'm like, wow, Lord. So anyone mention something about the kingdom of God? Well, subjects like
peace.
Okay, I'm fucking around. My hands tied already. I'm just kidding. I'll show you that one. Thank you, bro. Anyone else? Come on, we're all freedom.
Make sure you guys are writing this on your paper.
Yeah,
too.
Put it down.
Yeah,
I'm off. Okay.
Unshakable.
Unshakable. So, you must count it? Count it.
Unshakable.
Anyone else? righteousness.
Authority.
Authority. Truth. Otto. Power.
Bloodstains from the
serpents. Renee?
Life.
Yep. Because after this, we'll mention one of us.
Let's just know this means.
All right. Unity.
Wow.
Wow, awesome word. Nicole. Redemption.
Nice.
Yeah. 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 Amen.
Grace.
Grace.
Otto?
Blood of Jesus.
Blood of Jesus. Papa?
Faith.
Yeah. Faith.
Good.
Bear with me, I'm waiting for personnel to catch up. Faith. Yep. Next. Salvation.
Wow, amen.
Nitty.
Holiness.
Holiness.
Oh.
Yep. Let's go. Yeah. The Christian? Relationship.
Amen.
I like that. That's nice.
Amen.
Amen. Living? Lights?
No.
Yes.
Lights.
Light is good because it expresses darkness.
Amen.
Amen.
Pulpit?
Word of God.
Word of God. Anyone else? Lead?
Dominion.
Dominion.
I like that too.
Not this time because it's a good lesson today, because God really wants us. This is a simple study, but it's also a simple examination. Nicole.
Armor of God.
Armor of God. Martha.
Oh.
So we've got grace and forgiveness.
Wow.
Sibola?
Revelation.
Living water.
Living water.
Living water?
Living water? Yeah, living water. Anyone else? Copy?
Godhead.
Amen.
The Godhead.
Godhead.
Anyone else? Otto.
Angels.
Angels? Read on. Repentance.
Repent. After
for that, the last strength.
Strength.
Oh, that's a good one. Identity.
Did
someone say integrity?
Yes.
Yeah.
Integrity.
Yeah, I said it.
Victory!
Yeah,
you're the best.
Amen. Victory belongs to peace. Victory belongs to peace. Purity!
Oh, go, go.
Wow, look at this. Looks like I'm in a room for fresh air.
Saints.
So this looks pretty good, eh?
Yeah.
Amen? Praise God a lot then. So can we turn the board around now? Praise God.
Yeah, I know.
Yes.
Ew.
Okay. Kingdom of darkness, what is it, family? Sin? One more time, please. Bondage?
Bondage?
So,
condemnation.
Nice one.
Please mark this down, because you might need this later in your walk. Next. Unforgiveness.
Nice.
Ara?
Anger.
I'm putting you soon, and then I'll finish. And God, yep, unbelief.
Yep.
Mr. Steve.
Pride.
Ooh, pride. Pass the tongue.
Distraction.
Amen. Look at excuses. Yes. Okay. Bitterness.
That is so good.
Penny.
Idol.
Idol.
Straight over.
Tower.
Insecurity. Uh-oh.
Hypocrisy. No,
hypocrisy.
Ooh. I noticed you didn't write much down on this side.
Man. Angle?
Pride.
Thank you, God, Angle already. Thank you. God bless you. Alex.
Deception. Deception.
Deception. Guys, this is going to be awesome. What's the title?
Partiality.
Forgive me if I missed this, Lonely. Assumptions. That's true, that's kind of darkness. Oh, Rihanna? Tradition of man.
Yeah. Wow. Amen.
That's awesome. Laloa.
Division?
Oh, got it.
Oh, I mean, unforgiveness.
Are you writing it down?
No.
Rita? False humility. Mama?
Witchcraft.
Otto?
Lust.
Lust.
Backward.
Gossip.
So
Selena? Fornication.
Fornication.
Dirty.
Soulish prayers.
Soulish prayers. Pity.
Flesh.
Warren.
Murmuring.
Lies.
Laziness.
Manipulation.
Renee. Envy. Prophet Nella.
Confusion.
That's good. And you see something here, family? There's so much stuff in the kingdom of darkness. Exactly, there's always a counterfeit to the kingdom of God. Praise the Lord. I want to thank you for your awesome work. Wow. Did you know? If you look at the kingdom of darkness, let it turn this around. And look at the kingdom of light. God. It's exactly the same. So if you put this together, it's counterfeits of that. Amen? So that's kind of really the kingdom of God. So me and the Lord was praying, ask God what does he want to show us today. He wants you to learn to examine yourself, because when someone tells you something, the kingdom of God, something that Nasir shared last night was correct. He said, what is the scripture now that you gave me? Proverbs?
Proverbs 11:1. Okay, so it says a false balance is abomination to the Lord, but a just weight is his delight. So Apostle Tui was mentioning a few things to me today while we were downstairs. And we're just seeking the Lord on some things, and we have to understand that some things we just can't put a balance to it. It just is what it is. Does that make sense? We just need to call it for what it is. We can't say that we're doing too much of this if it's glorifying Jesus Christ. We can't say we're doing too much of one thing if it's still glorifying Jesus Christ. So, going from here, if you don't mind, to here, there's a scripture in 2 Corinthians chapter 13, verse 5. We'll all go there. So we've got to understand that this whole study is not directed to a certain person, individual. This is a refresher for everybody, but it's also there. We've got to understand this is new people here as well today. So if it's something that's unfamiliar in what they've been taught in the past, this is something that we've got to bring to their understanding as well. So whatever is brought forth today, don't take it personally as though we're directing it to anybody, because it's for all of us, even for me and Apostle Tui.
Yes.
Okay? So, 2 Corinthians 13, verse 5 says, examine yourselves whether you be in the faith. Prove your own selves, which means to test your own selves, how that Jesus Christ is in you. Except you be reprobates, which means disqualified. I'll read verse 6 as well. So it says, but I trust that you shall know that we are not disqualified. Okay? So we're all, put your hand up if you've accepted Jesus Christ into your heart as your Lord and Savior. Praise the Lord. So in the book of John chapter 1, verse 12, it talks about, if you believe in Jesus Christ, you you earn the right to be called a child of God. Okay? So it's not determined on your works, what calls you a child of God. It's by simply believing the Lord Jesus Christ.
Amen.
So, I have in 1 Thessalonians chapter 2, and we'll read the whole chapter because this is very necessary to the subject at hand today. Bless the Lord.
Amen.
And this is something that I love. I love doing reading scriptures with you all. So I just thank you, Lord, in Jesus' name, that that the Holy Spirit is here and works in all our hearts, opening our ears to hearing and understanding what the Spirit is saying to the church, and that our heart is open and willing to receive whatever you say today, Lord, in Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.
So 1 Thessalonians chapter 2, verse 1, reading through to the whole chapter. For yourselves, brethren, does everyone have this scripture? Does everyone? Is if you need help finding it, maybe give somebody a hand to find it. Okay, cool. You might have to move this out of the way just a touch so you can see the board if you don't have a Bible. Okay. 1 Thessalonians chapter 2, verse 1. For yourselves, brethren, know our entrance in unto you, that it was not in vain, but even that we had suffered before and were shamefully entreated, as you know, at Philippi, we were bold in our God to speak unto you the gospel of God with much contention. So this is Paul writing to the church in Thessalonians. And it talks about in Acts chapter 9 of Paul, who was called Saul previously, was actually a persecutor of the Church of Jesus Christ. And what happened was, at his conversion, Jesus Christ mentioned something to him that he will suffer a lot for the name of Jesus Christ. So this is what Paul is mentioning to the Church of Thessalonians, that what he went through just to come to the Church of Thessalonians is pretty much, he was doing it all for the sake of Jesus Christ and declaring boldly the gospel. So what is the gospel? The gospel is not just it's not just preaching words. It's actually it's the kingdom of God. Is that what we've got here? Kingdom of God. So after this chapter, I'll lead you to a verse of what the kingdom of God is and where it is. Okay. Verse 3. And our exhortation was not of deceit, nor of uncleanness, nor of guile, but as we were allowed of God to put in trust with the gospel, even so we speak, not as pleasing men, but God, which tests our hearts. Amen?
Amen.
Verse 5. For neither at any time use we flattering words, as you know, nor a cloak of covetousness, God is witness. Nor of men saw we glory. So in other words, Paul is mentioning we do not do anything to please man, but God. Okay, verse 6. Nor of men saw we glory, neither of you, nor yet of others, when we might have been burdensome as the apostles of Christ. But we were gentle among you, even as a nurse cherishes her children. So being affectionately desirous of you, we were willing to have imparted unto you not the gospel of God only, but also our own souls, because we were dear, because you were dear to us. So this is something that we want to help you all understand, is that we've submitted our lives to God, but we're subject to you all. If you don't understand, we're always here for you all. Not just here on Saturday, but you see us everywhere through the week, yeah? Do you agree? So we're not just we're not hirelings. We're not doing this for money. We're doing this because we're shepherds of your souls. We're not trying to be lords over you. we're trying to be examples, and that's just truth.
Amen.
Amen. Okay. Verse 9. For you remember, brethren, our labor and travail, for laboring night and day, because we would not be chargeable unto any of you, we preached unto you the gospel of God. You are witnesses, you are all witnesses, and God also, how holy and justly and unblameably we behaved ourselves among you that believe. As you know, this is verse 11, as you all know, how we exhorted and comforted and charged every one of you as a father does his children. And so I've mentioned this before, but I'll say it again. I'm not too much older than you all.
Amen.
I'm not too much older than you all. Some are older than me, but I look at you all as my children. Not as my physical children, but obviously me, Apostle Tui, guardians over your souls. And I'll continue on reading through and you'll see what I'm talking about. That you will walk worthy of God, who has called you unto his kingdom and glory. Amen?
Amen.
Verse 13, for this cause also, thank we God without ceasing, because when you received the word of God, which you heard of us, you received it not as the word of men, but as it is in truth, the word of God, effectually works also in you that believe.
Amen.
Amen. Verse 14, for you all, brethren, this is talking about a large number of people that he's talking to, brethren, became followers of the churches of God, which in Judea are in Christ Jesus, for you also have suffered like things of your own countrymen. This talk about persecution. Even as they have of the Jews, who both killed the Lord Jesus and their own prophets and have persecuted us, and they please not God and are contrary to all men, forbidding us to speak to the Gentiles that they might be saved, to fill up their sins always, for the wrath is come upon them to the utmost. Verse 17. But we, brethren, being taken from you for a short time in presence, not in heart, endeavoring the more abundantly to see your face with great desire. And I've said this as well before. Like, I love being in the presence of you all. Sometimes it is kind of grievous to see some of you go through trials, but I also know that it is necessary that we all go through them. Because it molds us, it shapes us for a purpose. It's not for no reason that we go through something. Some things we put ourselves through it, but still, there's a lesson to learn. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Okay. And that's what I was going to say. I love seeing you all. I really do. It brings joy. It brings joy to my heart. Okay, verse 18 says, wherefore we would have come to you, even I, Paul, once again, but Satan hindered us. Verse 19 and 20 is what I want to share with you all. For what is our hope or joy or crown of rejoicing are not even you in the presence of the Lord Christ, Jesus Christ, at his coming. For you are our glory and joy. So when we bring up teachings throughout Sundays or even throughout the week, our purpose is not to show how far we've come in our walk. Even maybe some of our intentions is to provoke you to jealousy, but it's our whole point, our whole purpose is that we all come up together. Not that the apostles be above you guys, but that we all be together. And so when we stand before the Lord at that day, we can say, look, Lord, we've labored, we've travailed through many hard times, but we made sure and we pray for these guys, our children, the people that you have brought to us, that they all come up higher. Not that we be above any of you guys, although we have different callings and stuff, such, but we want to bring everybody up together. Amen?
Amen.
Hallelujah. So, did you want to share something?
Oh yeah, praise the Lord. We have to understand our job is not just us two, but the eldership. You get it? As leaders, and we're charged best to, like, whatever the Lord shows us, we'll show you today. So there's a word I didn't see up here. The kingdom of God edifies.
Amen.
Edification.
Amen.
You get it? It encourages. It rebukes. It corrects. Amen. So you can see that. Like, so you have to understand, you get challenged in certain teachings. And then understand when you get challenged, what manifests this or that? So I'm gonna ask you a question. If you're gonna manifest darkness, give me a word from the picture, I was preaching on relationship. How would the enemy counter? Which one would he use? Alex?
Division.
Division. So, what comes in division? Anyone else?
Comparing?
Nice.
Anyone else?
Assumptions.
What else?
Pride.
So you understand, the enemy will find a way to come against the kingdom of God. So when someone's sharing something, the enemy goes, man, you know, become self-centered, you start, like, what's the word? Look for it. Confusion. See what confusion? If someone's preaching something or someone's doing something, the enemy wants to cause confusion. Because in the other side it says unity. Amen? So you have to examine what's manifesting out of my flesh. You get it? This is why I put this there, so you can see, like, oh man, I always do this. Memory. Man, do you see that? You know, like this, or memory. Gossip, it's there. You have to discern, like, you know, the scripture we use up, like, even this one.
Amen.
The scripture of Proverbs. False balance. False balance. Be simple concerning evil. Be wise concerning good. If this is manifesting, I'll give you what's manifesting. Darkness. And then what, in this funny, it leads to one thing. It doesn't lead to that. It leads to one thing. Darkness. Be simple. This is what we're trying to teach you. Like, we're trying to find a way to divert back up to Jesus. So we're trying to justify, and go back to the gospel. So if you get challenged in any area in the world, examine, where are you?
Amen.
Where are you? How are you going to take that challenge? So you have to look at this really deeply, because we've all done it. We had up. You have all had, you all made mistakes.
Yeah,
you all have, I hear that guy like this, yeah, I agree with you. You know, like, and next minute, you're, what's the word? What's the word down here? Then you start pampering.
Amen.
You start pampering the person that's murmuring. Then you fall into bondage. Then bitterness comes. Then excuses. They come out of you and you become insecure.
Amen.
Understand?
Amen.
It all comes under one, the power of darkness. Do you understand? The enemy is manipulation. Understand? He's going to try anyway to manipulate the word of God.
Amen.
Be concerned, wise concerning good. So, we go to the scriptures in Romans 16. 19.
Yeah.
That's it. So for your obedience is come abroad unto all men. I'm glad therefore on your behalf, but yet would I have it wise unto that which is good and simple concerning evil.
Amen.
So Paul was coming against division. This is up top.
two verses up, he's talking about marking that causes division. That causes division. Mark them, you know, like Paul is saying, be wise, you have to discern. This is examination for all of us. Which kingdom are you in when you get challenged? Are you in the kingdom of darkness, with murmuring and confusion? And then you start gossiping? Murmuring, like we've all been through this. And that's something the Lord showed me. I was praying to God, being there, I was praying, and they're like, Lord, what do you want us to preach today? We depend by circumstance. Amen?
Amen.
So Lord, what do you want us to preach today? And the Lord dropped down the board and said, I want you to do this and that. And then I walked in, okay, bro, the Lord showed me this. He goes, man, praise the Lord, you got the same thing. So bring you back, like something is not the wisdom of man, but the wisdom of God. So one thing Tana was sharing, Nella, can you turn this around, please? Turn this around. He's learning. Praise the Lord, awesome. So he's learning, again, praise the Lord. So we all seem to say, we all agree that we're under relationship, amen? We all agree with it. So we all agree, it's all about relationship. But isn't relationship one with holiness? But isn't relationship one with unity? Isn't relationship one with power? Peace, choice, righteousness. When did it become just that? Understand, the kingdom of God is one.
Amen.
The kingdom of God is one. Remember the fruits of the Spirit? Love, joy, peace. It's one, Spirit. Amen. This is one. This is not separate to that. This is not separate to that. This is all one. So something like Prophet Seal was sharing with us yesterday. The Lord showed him something, Seal. The Seal said that he realized he was trying to balance, as being a husband and an elder and a musician and all that. The Lord said, what are you doing? It's one.
Amen.
There's no balance in that. It's one. You're walking in the kingdom of God. When did they come? I need to be strong in this. I need to be strong here. Grace is enough.
Amen.
You know, like the scripture talks about that. There'll be a way of false doctrine and stuff, and it talks about like let your heart be established in grace.
Amen.
You know, like be established in the kingdom. So when you start murmuring about other subjects, you do this and that and that and that. Understand? That's all good. So what are you murmuring against? If someone's preaching on this and you don't like it, wait, that's the other side. So if it's manifesting something else, that's something I want to share with you guys. Me and Nella and all the elders here, we're watchmen of your souls. We have to give account to God for someone here that gets discouraged, because discouraged is the other side. Amen? Discouraged, like, we're not here to discourage no one, that's the other side, but we're here to edify and encourage.
Amen?
Amen? So, thank you for sharing that verse. Continue?
Yeah.
Okay, praise the Lord. So, what I'll do is, I'll get everyone to turn to, in their Bibles, Luke chapter 17, verse 21, and if we can get on this board, 1 Corinthians chapter 1, verse 10, please. So, Luke chapter 17, verse 21, and what we'll all do is we'll read this in our Bibles first. After we read this, then we'll go up to the board up here. Luke chapter 17, verse 21. And up here is 1 Corinthians chapter 1, verse 10. Thank you. Actually, Luke 17, verse 20 and 21, please. Sorry. Thank you, Jesus.
Amen.
Okay. Luke 17, verse 20. It says, and when he was demanded of the Pharisees when the kingdom of God should come, he answered and said, the kingdom of God comes not with observation. Verse 21, neither shall they say, lo here, which means look here, or lo there, which means look there. For behold, the kingdom of God is where?
In you.
Whereabouts? Over here? There? It's here. In your heart. Okay? So if some of us, we already know what this means, but I'll just expound on it. The actual definition in the Greek It actually means not something to be confused as a literal place. It's actually talking about the authority, and it's mentioned here, dominion of God, which means power. The power of God is here in you. Amen?
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
So, this is something that Jesus preached all through his walk, the kingdom of God. The kingdom of God. If you read through Matthew all the way through John, you'll see that's all that Jesus mentions. Kingdom of God, the kingdom of God. He's actually talking about the kingdom of God is at hand, not necessarily mean I'm establishing my kingdom here on the earth, but I want you to know that when you receive me, you believe on me, you become a child of God, and the authority that I have, you will also have as well.
Amen.
That's what he's saying. Amen. So what 1 Corinthians chapter 1 verse 10, this is Paul mentioning to the church of Corinth, saying, now I beseech you, brethren, which means I beg or I plead to you, by the name of our Lord Jesus Christ, let me get out of your way, that you all speak the same thing, and that there be no divisions among you, but that you be perfectly joined together in the same mind and in the same judgment. Amen? Praise the Lord. So this is the kingdom of God. There is unity, there's peace, we will all have the same mind, speak the same thing, and have the same judgment. All agree?
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
This is the point of breaking bread.
Thank you, Jesus.
So we can all learn to speak the same thing and have the same mind.
Amen.
And judgment, not necessarily like judging one another, but judgment being like discerning, you know, the same spirit. Amen? Want to share anything?
Praise the
Lord.
And so then I was talking about discerning spirits, but that's part of the kingdom of God, discernment. You get it?
Amen.
So discernment doesn't become man discernment, it becomes God discernment. So what does God say? Watch and pray? Or watch and talk?
Watch and pray. Amen.
Watch and murmur? Watch and pray. So something you have to understand of God. So, who's that texted earlier? It's all kind of something I realized in my walk. This is when God talks about when Paul. Let's get there. I want to read that 2 Corinthians chapter 12. So the Lord gave me a word. 2 Corinthians chapter 12, verse 8 to 10. For this thing I besought the Lord thrice that it might depart from me. And he said unto me, my grace is sufficient for you. For my strength is made perfect in weakness. Most gladly, therefore, I will rather glory in my infirmities, that the power of Christ may rest upon me. Therefore I take pleasure in infirmities, in purchases, in necessities, sake, for when I am weak, then I am strong. Am I strong? Amen?
Amen.
So you look at the scripture, we read this many times. Now I said, Lord, which I'll show you, Lord. And Lord says, did you know Paul was complaining? We're too focused on looking at the thorn, and all said, sometimes we're too busy looking at Satan. But God said, Lord, take this away from me. Lord, it's only three times. Thrice means three times. But God goes, I rebuke him and said, my grace is enough.
Come on.
You're in the kingdom. That should be enough for you. You're in the kingdom of God because all of this is in there. And then that's what Paul got the revelation. What did he say after verse 10? Oh man, when he got that, he goes, man, therefore I will rather glory in my infirmities, that the power of God may rest upon me in the kingdom. Because sometimes we're focused on too much of the enemy, we want to understand what kingdom, because you can turn into that kingdom or this kingdom. Power is a power of choice.
Yeah.
Which kingdom do you want to be in? So, when Paul got the rebuke from the Lord, then he goes in verse 10, therefore I take pleasure in my infirmities, in my trials. He goes, before he was like, Lord, take it away from me, like three times. And Lord gave him understanding. You're in my kingdom. Isn't that
Amen.
Enough?
Amen.
You need to get in my kingdom. You need to get into the relationship. You need to get into the power. You need to get into the truth. That's all in this. And the Lord was showing me this, because I was like, oh man. Because sometimes we're like, well, sometimes we come to our old wisdom of man and try to think, what form was it?
man, I just realized I was getting rebuked from the Lord. The answer was there. My grace is sufficient.
Amen.
It is enough for you. This is enough. Anything else is from the darkness. You understand? So that's what me and Miller are trying to push today. What God is trying to push to the ministry today. Understand that you are in here.
Amen.
But discern yourself before you answer. You get it? So you get challenged, but anything, you know, it could be anything. Like, picture, someone always talks all the time. You get it? Like, this man always talks. He ministers all the time. Where's that coming from?
Darkness.
Yeah, like, where's it coming from? Darkness? Comparison?
Complaining.
Jealousy? Where's it coming from? Okay, someone, it's like, let's put the little category. Someone's doing something, and you just look at them as man, and you're discerning wrong. You have to understand, because this guy's on there, praise God. This is meant to say, man, praise God. Hallelujah.
Amen.
It's meant to shine the light.
Amen.
Amen. But sometimes the light exposes our hearts.
Wow.
Amen.
Amen.
That's part of the kingdom. If you get exposed, hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen. And sometimes, because that will expose what darkness is trying to creep into your walk. You get us? That's something like, you know, is that what you're telling me around this? Wow, there's so much on this. And this is part of what? Examination. It's how you react to a circumstance. You understand?
Amen.
How do you react to a circumstance? This, darkness, or light? Because God will put you in a place where you get tested. Amen? Amen?
Amen.
Even if it looked wrong. Understand? Do you understand? Even if it looks wrong, only God knows. A certain, your eyes, we open by our sight of faith. So we look at a situation like, that's wrong. That looks so wrong. Why are they doing that? Blah, blah, blah. Have you ever went to a person and asked them? Too quick to judge. So, you know the kingdom of God, there's a word that God gave me this week as well. Understand? If someone's doing something, are we there to react or to understand? When we look at circumstance, do we murmur when someone's doing something? Okay, like marriage, like moving into a house, like doing something. Is this the first thing you do? So you have to understand that you must understand. So God will put you in an area to show where we are at in our walk. He's going to put a circumstance in front of us and say, how are you going to react to it? Are you going to murmur or are you going to turn around and identify? And say, praise the Lord. Man, that's awesome to hear about that. Or you moved in the house, praise God. What are you going to receive? Man, praise the Lord. That's awesome. praise God. I'm just nah, amen. We love you, Lord. So, what we need to discern is so important. We've been taught this many times, but you have to understand which kingdom are you in. Because a little leaven leavens the.
Oh, wow.
Remember, I shared that thing. This turns to that, into that, into that, and you don't realize you're in the kingdom of darkness altogether. It builds up. A little leaven leavens the whole lump. Call for this and know where you are in your walk. So the Lord taught me to understand. I thank the Lord. Because I used to sit there and use, what's in here? In here, where's that word? Assumptions. See, if you are assuming something, where's that coming from? How many times we assume something? Is that darkness? Guys, how many times will you assume something? Put your hand up. Yeah? Where's that in? Where? But we still do it. You know, we still do it. Why do we do it? Because we have to pray first. The Lord is going to teach us. The Lord is going to teach us to understand what He's doing, not through man's wisdom, not through our intellect, through God's wisdom that surpasses all understanding. Amen?
Amen.
So God challenged me in areas that, like, it doesn't make sense. And God said, what's that to you? You get it? What's that to you? When I pull people together, why do you question it? Oh, because of that person, and doesn't that put in that person and that house. I don't get it. Like, it doesn't make sense in my carnal mind. So what would you say to you? Purity. And the other side says purity. All things are pure to them that's pure.
Amen.
So when you get the call, it shows where you are in your walk. It shows you, I'll be honest, this is straight truth. If you're murmuring, you're in darkness. If you have unforgiveness, you're in darkness.
Amen.
If you're in bondage, you're in darkness. You know, like, if you're trying to justify yourself, you're in darkness. Because it says in the New Testament that He justifies us. So if God is for us, He can be against us. So you understand, God will test you in the area to see if His grace is enough. You get it? So in many times I've been caught in a shaking moment, but thank God for the shaking. So in the other side, it has chastening of the Lord. Because He rebukes them that He loves. Amen. And this is what God told me in the other side. This is, okay, so I'll put a word here. Yeah, thank you, bro. Immaturity.
Amen.
So, in darkness, there's immaturity. But there's also immaturity in the other side, too. But immaturity can make stupid calls. You understand?
Yep.
And the other side is maturity. You get it? So there's babies in the Lord, amen. But sometimes that's a poor, because I talk to you as carnal, you know, like, and He understands that where you are. So there's immaturity in that side. But I want to share here, sometimes this leads to that, and that, and that, and that. But you have to learn to understand before you make a call on anything. You understand? So this is what the enemies are trapping you. He's going to trap at you. Man, are you serious? What's that word? there's so much words here. Where's hypocrisy?
Yeah, on the left.
Yeah. He goes, man, they're such a hypocrite. I remember I said this before, man. Far out, but the next minute that you go in front of them and your false humility in front of them. Is that true?
Yeah.
Wow, you know, in front of them, like, oh, praise the Lord, man. I love you, brother. And then this man, you know, got division. You know, like, and this man, you got hate.
Wow.
You have to deserve this. You know, like, and then you're distracted by their war. You understand? You're in the kingdom of darkness then. That's all the example. So don't be too quick to speak, be quick to listen.
Amen.
Before you speak.
Amen. Amen.
That's what I'm trying to say here today. If you're just speaking, then maybe you're there. Amen? Because God speaks life. Let me take this one, please, one more time. I like this. I like this too.
Amen.
Doesn't mean I don't like that and that. I don't like when you preach life. And someone preaches on righteousness, and goes, oh, no, it's not about righteousness, it's about being my life. You know, balance. But this is one.
Amen.
You understand what I'm trying to teach you? Don't be deceived by the enemy, because when you start feeling you go through a trial because of something someone said, or someone taught, or someone's doing, then you're focused on their work. Be focused on Jesus. So, I thank the Lord, because when we're here, we're meant to speak life to each other. Amen? Speak life. So, and also, this comes under warning.
You serious?
Okay.
So if we speak life to you, then we warn you. Amen?
Yeah, amen.
So exactly what we're doing now. Warning for you is through revelation. From who? From the Lord. So it gives you us peace, and you have to make the choice to which kingdom you're going to. Amen? So that's something we have to understand. It's because we're bringing you guys to repentance. Let us talk about the goodness of God brings us to repentance. This is His goodness. And I thank the Lord to understand that His grace is enough.
Amen.
Grace is not one thing. That's not just grace. Grace is the whole thing. You understand? So that's what I'm trying to teach you guys today. Sometimes guys are stronger than you in certain areas, right? Amen?
Yeah, amen.
So someone might be strong in bias. That he always speaks truth, boldness. Well, that person, man, that guy's so peaceful, man. Wow, that guy has great faith. Oh, man, that guy is, like, he's saying, you know, he's like, say beginning. And I'm like, you understand? But he doesn't do this. Man, that guy does that too much. Why are you trying to put that person into your box?
Yeah.
Oh.
You understand? Why you just put each other in each other's boxes? Because the office in grace, everyone has different strengths. You understand? We're not all, you know, we all have this, but everyone has different order. You get it? So someone might be strong in moving in truth, word of wisdom. Someone might be strong in word of knowledge. Someone might be a tana, teacher. Some of these are teachers here too. Get it? So understand, like, don't put each other in each other's boxes. Because if you just hold this, understand, I believe it is this. But that's what manifests is out of this. But if you just disregard that, that's not about relationship with Jesus with no power, because power comes with relationship. You understand? Unity comes with relationship.
Amen.
Because what's a relationship without this? What's a relationship? Because in the Old Testament, they have a relationship with God. But now we have relationship with Jesus. I understand, there's a relationship in the Old Testament with Moses and that. There's a relationship in grace. It's not about religion, it's about relationship. But I'm trying to share here today to understand, without this, then it's not relationship. You understand? It's not relationship until you have all these. If you're lacking in moving in... Let me guess. Okay. Power's right there. You see? Relationship, right? If you're lacking in power, do you put that down? Do you say, no, it's not about power, it's about relationship? Or how about, man, you always talk about authority, it should be about relationship. We understand that. But we have to be next to the whole gospel.
Yeah.
Understand? Everything comes from the kingdom of God. It's not about what we want, it's about what He wants.
Come on, amen.
You get it? Because sometimes we can be so carnal and do what we want to do. And that's the message today. I thank God for the salvation of God. Because now ministers are minister salvation all the time. Amen? Amen?
Amen?
And people that minister on prayer all the time. True? And people that minister on freedom all the time. True? People that talk on integrity and adoption of the Son, foundation. But what happens when we disagree? We shouldn't talk about that too much. Or that too much. Or this too much. What's that coming from?
Kingdom of darkness.
Darkness. Give me a word. What word in darkness?
Confusion.
Confusion. Amen. So, you understand? The enemy is here to cause confusion. Amen.
Praise the Lord. Our goal is to equip you all. Every single one of you. Oldies and youngies. So we are the little children, just for those who are new here or still kind of unfamiliar with faces, this ministry, we don't just minister on one topic. We cover the whole kingdom of God. Everything that there is to know about the scriptures, we all study it and we all go together. Because our whole purpose is for all of us to come up together. So we all come up in a point of maturity together. So we can't just say that he doesn't want me. I'll share a little testimony. We were at outreach one time, and just talking to everybody. And this one of the leaders was had a divine appointment. An appointment that was set up by God. So this one individual was just willing and just available there, just for God to use. Anyway, so one person was drawn to what we were doing at this outreach. Just loving God. We were singing songs of praise. And there was people over here just dancing and doing skits, and there was people over here singing. People over here just praying for somebody, and others over there just blessing people as they were walking by. And one individual walks up to this person, and he just starts talking to this person. Because I don't remember who it was, but this individual who came from the street asked which one's the pastor, because he didn't know which one was the pastor, because everyone's been taught the Bible. You understand? So that's our whole point. We have a vision. We have a vision for this church. Everyone be able to be led by the Holy Spirit of God.
Amen.
And to know the word. Everything in context. So there's a verse that I want to share with you all. 1 Corinthians chapter 12, and it goes from 18 to 26. It says, "But now God has set members, every one of them, in the body, as it has pleased him. And if they were all one member, where were the body? But now are they many members, but yet one body. If the eye cannot say unto the hand, and the eye cannot say unto the hand, I have no need of you, nor again the head to the feet, I have no need of you. Verse 22, nay, much more, those members of the body which seem to be more feeble are necessary." Okay, just to kind of expound on that, it's not saying I'm an eye or Apostle Tui is an ear, but it's just giving a description that every single one of you in the body of Christ is necessary. You're all valuable and you're all important in the body of Christ. Okay? So it says in verse 23, "And those members of the body which we think to be less honorable, upon these we bestow more abundant honor. And our uncomely parts have more abundant comeliness." So the ones who may think that they're of no value in the body, we show them honor. So anyone who doesn't know me very well, I'm one of the elders, anointed as an apostle in Christ Jesus. I don't boast in anything. I'm approachable. Anyone can approach me. Anyone can talk to me. Those who know me well, they know me as a humble person. I just love everybody. I live truth and I speak the truth. I'm just me.
Amen.
That's just what God has done in my life.
Amen.
I won't treat anybody else any different. I have no partiality in me. Amen. And I don't expect it just from me. I expect it from everybody. Okay, so verse 24, "And our comely parts have no need, but God has tempered the body together, having given more abundant honor to them, to that part which lacks, that there be no schism in the body," which means that there be no division or partiality among the body, "but that the members should have the same care one for another. And whether one member suffers, all the members suffer with it. Or one member be honored, all members rejoice with it."
Amen.
Amen. So this ministry, it's only a small ministry, well, here it is anyway, but continues to grow. But we've been through many shakings. When I say shakings, I mean like Satan hates this church, this ministry. He hates it. And so many times, yeah, amen, good. But we all hate him, praise God. Is that what I mean?
Amen.
So many times he's tried to cause division among the brethren, among the eldership. He's tried to do certain little things in the body to try and affect the eldership, trying to affect the eldership, to try and destroy the body. He's trying to do everything. But praise God that our relationship is not firm. We need to go. Come on, Jesus Christ, and be good. And we bless God. Have a look at this, right? It's in 1 Peter chapter 5, verse 8. So this is still a part of examining. Because, like I mentioned, we're trying to equip you. We want you guys very sharp with the word, sharp with discernment, and identifying what the enemy is trying to do with every single person here. 1 Peter chapter 5, verse 8. Because we do know that Satan is defeated, talks about in Colossians 2, that Jesus Christ disarmed all principalities. Everything that Satan, all the powers that Satan has, he's still got power, but to those who believe, he's been disarmed. He's got no authority over you. To the unbelievers, he still does have a power over them. But listen to this. This is Peter talking to the saints. When I say saints, someone who's come to Christ Jesus, been sanctified by the blood of Jesus. 1 Peter chapter 5 verse 8 says, be sober, which means to be in control of your mind. Be vigilant, which means to be cautious and watch. Because your adversary, which is the devil, as a roaring lion, walks about seeking who he may devour. That's his goal. He's trying to find anyone who's not focused on the Lord Jesus Christ. Anyone who's actually entertaining the kingdom of darkness is gone. Bang, I've got you. I've got you right where I want you. That's his whole purpose. Do you understand? So, it talks about in Colossians 3 that if we've been risen with Christ, we need to set our affection on the things above. Where Christ sits at the right hand of God. So if our affection and our desires are on the things here on this earth, being consumed by worldly desires, you're going to have mind battles. The kingdom of darkness is going to play around with your heart, manipulate what was pure thoughts. It's going to start making you think evil towards your brethren, evil towards the eldership. It's going to make you do these things and even make you forget your testimony and make you even think of going back to the world where you came from. But the point is, like, he wants to make you even worse than before you came to Christ. His whole goal. You guys understand?
Yes.
Praise the Lord. Amen. This is a part of examination. Part of understanding the kingdom of God and the kingdom of darkness. Bless the Lord.
Amen.
2 Corinthians chapter 2, verse 11. Have a listen to this. This excites me. Because we've all been equipped, we've got no excuse here.
Amen.
2 Corinthians chapter 2 verse 11 says, lest Satan should get an advantage of us, for we are not ignorant of his devices.
Amen.
Ignorant actually means that we're not unaware.
Amen.
We have not been, we have been taught. We know what, plus also that we go through trials. We fall from time to time, but we're supposed to learn from these. We're supposed to learn from these as lessons. So we know that Satan has been defeated. We know that, but we still need to watch and pray. Because if we start to entertain ungodly thoughts, you need to understand that Apostle Alan always mentions it as well, about being born again. Touches on it quite often, about being born again. Our hearts have been renewed. Talks about in Ezekiel that God has given us a new spirit. He's given us a new heart. To the people of the world who are not saved, their hearts are corrupted. Their minds are being defiled. Nothing they do is pure. The thing is, we've been made new. We're born again. We're children of God. And we've been taught the truth. The choice lies with us, whether we're going to abide in the truth and live the truth. Amen?
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
I'll share something with you, right? I mentioned earlier in the verse about having a sober mind. A mind that is sober means that you're free from corruptness. Drunkenness, according to the scriptures,
actually describes somebody that is without control, without self-control. Whether you be tempted in something and you have no control over it, but it has control over you. Okay? But this is the whole point of the kingdom of God. Let me turn this around. This is the whole point of the kingdom of God. Like I mentioned earlier, it's not something to be mistaken as a literal kingdom, but it's actually God's authority, God's power and dominion in your heart, in you. But it's not there to just sit there dormant. It's supposed to be used for a purpose to continue overcoming what the enemy tries to do with you.
Amen.
Manipulating thoughts, thoughts of ungodliness, thoughts of evilness, unforgiveness, bitterness. We're supposed to continue denying, leaving these things aside, because we're born again.
Amen.
Yes, we are.
Yes, we are. Amen.
Amen.
Bless the Lord.
Amen.
In this heart, there's a word should be here as well, dead. It talks about that we are dead and we're hidden in Christ in Colossians 3. Amen. Amen. So, but it says in Galatians chapter 5, verse... Yes, dead in Christ. So, Galatians chapter 5, verse 16 and 17. So, on us here. So, if you go to verse 15 first, it says, but if ye bite and devour one another, take heed that ye be not consumed of one another. And it says, this I say, then walk in the Spirit, they shall not fulfill the lust of the flesh. Alright? But what happens after that? For the flesh will lust against the Spirit. That's the Spirit, and the Spirit is the flesh. And these are contrary to one to the other, so that you cannot do the things that you would. But if you be led of the Spirit, you are not under the law. So, understand you are dead, but let us share the scripture about the devil being a roaring lion. You understand? There is still a fight. You get it? So the fight is trying to confuse you to say that you're alive. So it's alive, but also saying that. So Satan, how did Satan tempt Jesus in the wilderness? He said, he made him hungry. Jesus was hungry, and then commanded his stone to come bread. Then he tempted him with the riches of this world.
Even
charged twisting scriptures on him and jumped off this cliff. Also, he used a lot of things to manipulate Jesus Christ. So it's the same to you. So it's the flesh versus spirit. So there will always be a fight in the world. So it says, do not be troubled of these things, because you know that there's going to be a fight. There is. The trial of your faith is more precious than gold. So we go there, 1 Peter. 1, I'm guessing 7. It was alright? Yes, praise God. So, let's go to verse 6 first, please. Wherein ye greatly rejoice, for now, for a season, if need be, you are in heaviness of manifold temptation. Okay? So go through many battles, temptation, the enemy is testing you, see where you are in your walk. He wants you to manifest flesh. Okay? But he says, remember that the trial of your faith, being much more precious than gold, that perisheth, though it be tried with fire, might be found unto praise and honor and glory at the appearing of Jesus Christ. Amen?
Amen?
So, you have to be squeezed. I remember someone sharing something about an orange. When you squeeze an orange, what comes of an orange?
Juice.
You know, does apple juice come out? No. So, us as big Christians, when we get squeezed, what comes out? No, blood. That's it. The squeezing is temptation. The enemy testing you. What should be coming out of us? Jesus. So the kingdom of God. This, when someone's like, Peter, someone's like, man, this sermon is like, what do you reckon? You should say, you should confront them. I'm praying, let's pray for them.
Amen.
I'm praying, like, I saw this. Right. The reason of this light is to expose every darkness in us.
Yeah, amen. Right?
So that's what the light does. It brings everything, like, it exposes your hearts. Yeah. Amen?
Amen?
So I'm going to use one more scripture. This scripture said powerful to me, this chapter, 1 Peter 13.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
So we know that scripture in John 3:16. Amen?
Yeah, amen.
So, with one voice and then, okay. One, two, three. So... That's just pretty good. Okay, again. One, two, three.
For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever shall believe in him shall not perish, but have everlasting life.
Amen.
Amen.
Thank you, Lord, for the kingdom. Amen. So I thank God for the kingdom. So now, 1 Corinthians 13, we're going to hold chapter. Amen.
Yes.
1 Corinthians chapter 13. Hallelujah. God is good.
All the time.
More time.
God is good.
More time.
God is good.
Hallelujah. Okay. Though I speak with the tongues of men and of angels and have not charity, which means love, without love, I have become a sounding brass or a tinkling, and while I have the gift of prophecy and understand all mysteries, I'm so smart, and all knowledge, and though I have all faith, so that I could remove mountains and have not love, charity, I have nothing. So you can sit there and go, man, I've got this word. Remember I said the wisdom of man? Not speech is through excellency. Man's wisdom. Words, shut up, words just to look good. It's not about that. It's about the demonstration of his power through your mouth. That's a minister of fire. What comes from the Holy Spirit speaks through you. Amen?
Amen.
So that's what shows the charity is in you. The love of God manifests from your mouth. Amen?
Amen.
Charity! Oh, what did oh yeah. Sorry, I'm wrong. Verse 3, hallelujah. And though I bestow all my goods and feed the poor, and though I give my body to be burned and have not charity, love, it profits me nothing. Wow. Charity suffers long and is kind. Charity endeth not. Charity wanteth not itself, it's not puffed up. Does not behave itself unseemly, seeketh not her own, is not easily perverted evil. So that means no record of wrong.
Amen.
Remember, God said, when you come into his kingdom, I remember your sin no more. But sometimes you're like, oh, but remember your past. You understand what I'm saying? When someone's repented, believe it.
Amen.
Trust God with them. But don't move them because we're in the past. That's the Satan. Because when someone became into repentance, they'll change.
Amen.
Believe God. Amen?
Amen.
Rejoices not in iniquity, but rejoices in the truth. What we're sharing today, Jesus is the truth.
Amen.
It beareth all things. It bears all things. It believes all things, it hopeth all things, and it endures all things. This is love. This is love we're talking about here. You don't realize what love is. You put others before yourself. Jesus was a perfect example. When Jesus did not come down for myself, I came to do the will of God. Then he came down to die on the cross. Did Jesus go for a battle? Yes. He sat there and Lord, you know, like, take this cup away from me. Yeah, first shall I attack, but he's like, not my will, but yours. Amen?
Amen.
So, Jesus showing us that there's a will in the flesh that he wants to not do, but he knew what the will of Father is. Amen?
Amen.
Charity never faileth, but whether there be prophecies, they shall fail. Whether there be tongues, or they also cease. Whether there be knowledge, it shall vanish away. For we know in part, and we prophesy in part, but when that which is perfect, so I say which is complete, is come, then that which is part shall be done away. When I was a child, I spake as a child, I understood as a child, I fought as a child, but when I became a man, I put away childish things. So what's the childish things?
Self-centered.
Flesh. Okay. For now we see through the glass,
ugly, but then face to face. Now I know in part, but then so I know even as also I know. Now abide faith, hope, charity, love. These three, but the greatest of these is charity, love.
Amen.
So something that Pastor Tana said, understand the reason why we're here, because we love Jesus.
Amen.
The reason we preach the word is because we love Jesus.
Amen.
The reason I'm preaching is because we love Jesus. The reason why you're here is because you love Jesus.
Amen.
So we're trying to encourage you guys to bring the truth to you guys, because sometimes truth hurts, amen? Sometimes it hurts, don't want to hear the truth. But we have to preach truth, grace and truth. Amen? Because when you're too if you're too focused in other things, then don't be distracted by the darkness. So praise the Lord.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Put your hand up, you're edified today.
The kingdom of darkness and the kingdom of light. I want to share with you something. There's certain laws in countries that are permitted there, in other countries that are not permitted here. Would you agree?
Yes.
Like for instance, I know my family overseas, they tend to drive around with their infants. Not in the car seat, not in the baby seat, but just holding them and saying it's okay because they'll get away with it. But there's a law here that says you can't do that. Every child has to have a baby seat, a child seat. Does that make sense? So in the same manner, this is like the kingdom of heaven and the kingdom of God. This is when awesome preaching by the apostles.
Amen.
Amen.
When you're in the kingdom of God, it's not that you're going from one kingdom to another, because it contradicts what the Bible talks about. Does that make sense? You can still be in the kingdom of God and practice things, just like you can still be here and practice something that you practiced overseas before. Like for instance, when I was in Kenya, we were driving and overtaking and doing a lot of illegal things that we're not allowed to do here, but it was permitted there. But now we've come here, there's certain laws and regulations that we abide by. So with the kingdom of heaven, this is what we abide by.
Amen.
Just because you fall to, can we take this? Just because we fall to this, doesn't mean you're in this kingdom. It means you're still in the kingdom of God, leading to light to this.
Yes.
Does that make sense?
Amen.
You're still in the kingdom of God. Like for instance, there's now no condemnation for those who are in Christ Jesus. Now, this is the catch. You walk in the spirit and not in the flesh.
Amen.
So it's still saying that you've given your life to Christ. Yes, but there's no condemnation for those who are in Christ Jesus. Now the choice is this, whether you walk in the flesh or in the spirit.
Amen.
Does that make sense?
Amen.
This is where the word of God, like, it makes it more simple to understand where you stand in the kingdom of God, and you're not just jumping from kingdom to kingdom. You're still in the abiding of the kingdom, but there's things to your flesh that you need to die to. It doesn't mean you've stepped out of the kingdom of God, because the scripture says that he's taken you out of the power of darkness and translated you into the kingdom of God. This is what he's done. He's taken you from here, put you here. There's still things in the flesh that you're still practicing every now and then. Like for instance, one of the most common ones that we struggle with is assumptions. From time to time, we tend to assume things. Now this is the thing. Just because you're in the kingdom of God, you don't have to go to the kingdom of darkness to practice assumptions. You can still go against the law of Christ, just in the flesh. Does that make sense? So one thing that the Lord was showing me in that, like Apostle Tui was sharing about understanding, you know, one thing that conquers understanding is peace.
Wow.
One thing that conquers understanding is seeking peace. Because sometimes, even in our understanding, we're seeking the right motives. We're seeking something that makes sense to us. doesn't necessarily, what makes sense to God doesn't necessarily mean it has to make sense to us. This is what the Lord in the Old Testament, he says, there are many plans in the heart of man, but God's will prevails. But that said, even if you don't understand my ways or don't understand my plans, I'll give you peace if you seek. If you seek him, he can just give you peace. So it doesn't matter what's going on in your life or in your circumstance. It doesn't matter what's going on in your situation, whether someone else in the program is going through something. You still have peace that surpasses understanding, that conquers understanding. So something that the Lord had been ministering to me lately so far is the power of confession. Because distraction is dangerous. It's your leaven already leading to the lump. But confessing that you're lacking focus actually kills the distraction. Or in other terms, I'll turn it the other way around. When we deny the fact that we're losing focus in Christ, we empower the distraction that's holding us in bondage.
Sure.
We start to empower that distraction. Rather than doing this, humble yourself, seek the face of Jesus, and he will heal you. Confess your faults one to another and pray for one another that you may be healed. This is what the kingdom of heaven does. But sometimes in our walk, we sort of have this front or image that we have to try and keep as a man of God or a woman of God. And we don't want to let anyone else know that we're going through trials. We don't want to let anyone else know that we're getting distracted in our walks. And that's one of the biggest works of the enemy is distraction. Because it says he walks around as a roaring lion, seeking whom he may devour. Just that split distraction. And the power of confession, the power of being humble before the Lord, the power of prayer and seeking his face to be delivered from all this, will break the power of distraction in your life. Praise the Lord. Give glory to God. I'm not sharing with you guys so you can all go and share your burdens to one another. It's being real with the Lord.
Amen.
That's what it is. It's being real with God. Where you can say, Lord, but I'm not doing so well in my walk. I really need you. And not saying it in a cliche way where you're saying, Lord, I'm a typical Christian, I need you. No, you're saying it from the depths of your heart.
Amen.
You're confessing even the deepest darkest secrets in your heart, saying to the Lord, Lord, take this from me. Right?
Amen.
And that's where the worship in the spirit of truth comes out, when the distraction is broken in the power of the name of Jesus. By your confession and being able to be transparent before the Lord, being able to say, Lord, I'm clear for you to see me. Yeah. Glory to God.
Amen.
There is something that the enemy really, maybe not even anyone new in the faith, but anyone who's kind of like gone through some struggle in their walk, there's a word called condemnation, and it's something that Satan really thrives on the hearts of the Christians. Condemnation is something that makes you feel so guilty, and it makes you think that you're unworthy to walk with Christ. It makes you feel like you haven't been forgiven. But I share something that was mentioned earlier, confession. The Bible says, if you confess your sins to God, God is faithful and just to forgive you of your sins. And it says that he will cleanse you from all unrighteousness. The Bible explains that if your hearts condemn you, God is greater than your hearts. You need to understand, if you've repented of your sins, which means that you knew what was wrong, you've asked the Lord for forgiveness, you've given it to him, saying in your heart, I don't want this anymore, Lord. It's weighing me down and it's stopping me from glorifying you with all of my heart, all of my mind, all my strength. If you give it to God, God will give you, says in his word, your forgiveness.
Amen.
Yeah? So, if it says in the Bible, if God says that your sins are forgiven and I remember it no more, that's what it means.
Amen.
He remembers it no more. And if there is still thoughts of thinking that you're not forgiven,
It's all a lie. Okay? Just for you to understand that. God is faithful and just to forgive you of your sins. Okay? Amen. Bless the Lord.
Amen. Praise the Lord. Without shared to understand the power of God, it's going to manifest in this place today.
Amen.
So let's help God understand. So the message today is to discern where you are in your walk. To discern what you say out of your mouth. Because we understand what flesh comes out of flesh and what comes out of spirit. I believe that's the Lord showing that today. Discern yourself. Amen?
Amen.
So understand the reason the Lord showed this, like I know that I'm in the hospital. The Lord wants you to bring it to expose darkness. Amen? For you to make darkness, but to show you what is darkness. It says about drunkenness, fornication. So we turn to understand we came to grace of God. And what I share with you guys is the ministry of reconciliation. Amen? And Apostle Tana said there is no condemnation in Christ. Amen? So we want to understand the enemy will try to take you away from this peace. But remember this peace you're feeling now, because I know I'm starting to see a glory clouds now. Praise God, it's manifesting right now in the name of Jesus Christ. Father, in the name of Jesus, Lord, I ask you more. I want to thank you for the word. Lord, if someone does not understand, Lord Jesus, you give them understanding. Let us understand, Lord Jesus, that you are God. Let us be still and learn that you are God. Let us understand your wisdom. Thank you, Jesus, for your peace that surpasses our understanding. Jesus. I ask you to fill every person in here, Lord, with your joy and peace. Every part and spirit of God. I want to thank you for the kingdom, Lord Jesus.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord, for your grace. We praise you, Jesus. I want to thank you, Lord Jesus, that you call us children of God. Thank you, Lord Jesus, that you call us daughters and sons.
Thank you.
Lord, I want to thank you, Lord, that we are a new creation. Thank you, Lord, for renewing our hearts and renewing our minds. Thank you, Lord, in Jesus' name. That we're moving our areas from you to glorify you alone and no one else. Thank you, Lord. Teach us to provoke each other even more into good works. I want to thank you, Lord. The power of your Holy Spirit. May you fill this place right now, Lord Jesus. Fire the Holy Spirit, Lord. Fire the name of Jesus. Fire the Holy Spirit, the name of Jesus. Fire the name of Jesus Christ. Fire the name of Jesus Christ. May you manifest your glory in this place right now, in the name of Jesus. Fire in the name of Jesus. Fire in Jesus' name. Thank you, Lord, for the Holy Spirit fire. Thank you, Lord Jesus. All darkness stays in your presence. Thank you, Lord. Lord, I ask you more in the name of Jesus Christ. If there's anyone here, Lord Jesus, I ask you, touch them with your peace. Touch them with your joy. Thank you, Lord, for the power of the Holy Spirit, Lord Jesus. Lord, bring us back to our first works in the name of Jesus Christ. All yes, all condemnation, go in Jesus' name. Get out in the name of Jesus Christ. Thank you, Lord, for the Holy Spirit, Lord Jesus. Thank you, Lord Jesus, that your light exposes darkness today. I want to thank you, Lord Jesus, for worship in the name of Jesus. And I will end with Jesus Christ. Thank you, Lord, for you. Thank you, they set them free in the name of Jesus. Glory in the name of Jesus Christ.
name of Jesus Christ. Out. Thank you, Lord. I count every soul tired and life alive in me right now in the name of Jesus. Get out in Jesus' name. Thank you, Lord, for your love and your peace, Lord Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Let's speak to the saints. Hallelujah.
Cleanses every saint from all unrighteousness.
In the name of Jesus Christ, we thank you, Lord, for your peace upon their hearts. The blood of Jesus Christ, you are forgiven in Jesus' name.
Thank you, Lord, for the deliverance.
Yes, Lord. Fill them afresh, Lord. Strengthen them in Jesus' name.